tonight on Axis TV, straight from New York City, it's Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Pete Dominick, Hadiyah Robinson, Dante Nero, Dave Landau, and your host, Pamela Anderson.
Wow. That's why, you know, I could not do this without hair. Welcome to Gotham Comedy Live in New York City. How's everybody doing? Sounds good. We have a great show for you tonight, and everybody in the cast is on the way up in show business. It's the complete opposite of Sharknado movie. And we're coming to you live from New York City. How cool is that? I love this city. I actually ran the New York City Marathon a few years ago. It took me 5 hours to finish. It would have been faster, but Chris Christie closed the bridge. I just wanted to start by saying I'm a proud vegan. And I mention that because as a vegan, we're required to work that into the first sentence of every conversation. Last week, I wrote a letter to the governor of California asking him to make all the state prisons go vegan. It will save them money, and it will save so many beautiful animals. Because in 2016, animals aren't meant to be food. They're meant to be funny YouTube videos. Plus, a lot of studies show that vegans have the most active sex lives. I got excited, sorry. So don't worry, ladies. Even if you go vegan, you still get plenty of meat. I've been married 3 times because I'm a hopeless romantic. I always get my hopes up, but it never, ever works out. It's like being a Knicks fan, being a Knicks game. Sorry. I can't really make fun of the Knicks because I'm from the Los Angeles. I'm from Los Angeles, and our Lakers are not doing great right now. No Kobe. The Lakers actually had a promotion this year where all the tickets were $5 to get in and $500 to get out. But I don't watch a lot of sports because we have so many other crazy things going on in the world. And by the way, did you see that Hulk Hogan got $115 million for his sex tape? That pissed me off. All I got were some stupid Motley Crue tickets. Of course, the new trend now is that a lot of single people are dating couples. At least that's what I keep telling attractive couples when I meet them. This is so much fun. I've always wanted to try stand-up because I was inspired by all the great female comedians we've had. There's Joan Rivers, Phyllis Diller, Andy Dick. Andy wanted to be here tonight, but he couldn't come because we're within 500 feet of a school. I love Andy. It's harmless. They're actually making a Baywatch movie. I'm still not sure that I'm going to do it. In my Playmate data sheet, it stated that one of my life goals is to win an Oscar. And let's face it, the only way I'm getting an Oscar from Baywatch is if I find one in the sand with a metal detector. I've got a ton of great movie projects right now, but all of the films I've done, the one that everyone always asks me about is Borat. People always want to know what it was like meeting Borat. They always ask. Okay, he's a nice guy, but he speaks in really crude English, and he has some disgusting views about women. It's like hanging out with Donald Trump. Did you see Donald on the news today? He was in a bad mood. He must have woke up on the wrong side of the tanning bed. A lot of people say they'll move to Canada if Trump wins. And that's okay, except my friend Seal, who is worried he might get clubbed to death. That was for me. But I really think we're ready for a woman in the White House. Think about it. Not only is she qualified, But if we elect a female president, it will save us so much money on salary. Okay, are you guys ready to start the show?
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Pete Dominick is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. More great stand-up coming your way starting right now.
Welcome back. Let's start the show. You can hear our first comic every day as the host of Stand Up with Pete Dominick on SiriusXM Satellite Radio. Please welcome Pete Dominick!
Keep it going, everybody! How about that? Holy shit! Thank you very much, Pamela Anderson, is a sentence I never thought I would say out loud and have you hear it. I just never thought you would hear me say it. So, I love you. It's weird. She's much more than, though, just a sex symbol. A very, an amazing activist. Seriously, an amazing activist and a business person. And it's really, I'm a huge feminist. I have two daughters, and I want my daughters to grow up to be just almost exactly like you. Like, mostly, minus a couple of things, just like you. And I also want to have sex with you. So, anyway. You guys are like, oh, I can't believe he said what we wanted to say to her our whole lives. Yeah, I never know. You meet a famous icon like Pamela Anderson or anybody. You don't know. You think you know what to say. You think you're going to have a great conversation because you've thought about them. You're a fan of them. I've had the most awkward conversations with the most famous people for like the last 15 years. I'll never forget. I met John Grisham, the best-selling, you know, legal thriller novelist. And I said, the guy, oh, no, don't. Clay, he's not here. So that's weird. But no, I said, I'm talking to John Grisham backstage at this TV show, and I go, Mr. Grisham, I'm a big fan. I loved Time to Kill. That was great. It's a great book. He's like, thank you very much. I appreciate it. I go, yeah, I like a lot of your books. He's like looking for security. And then I just said the same thing I said to Pamela Anderson. I was just like, I also want to have sex with you. What's wrong? Why am I don't know what to say. Are you guys used to my head? My look? Is that, do you need more time? I know, it's weird. It's a weird look. It is. It's a weird. You see a bald white guy with a beard, and you're like, that is either one of two people. It is an intellectual gay guy or a heterosexual pedophile. There's no other. You look at this bald, this black guy who's like at almost bald. I don't know what your situation is, but nobody. You look at that guy. You're like, good look. That's a good look. You look at me. You're like, get the kids. This is a creepy. Look at this camera guy. Can we give me your camera? All I want you. I want to be you. Look at this guy. I want to look like a Norwegian serial killer. I want this guy's look. Seriously, I want to look like Hitler's dream. Look at this guy. Seriously, this guy's look is the main argument for background checks on guns. Stop doing that. All right, thanks, man. What's your name? Brian, give it up for, that's what I want, your hair. I just want him. Holy shit. That guy is definitely gonna be on the front page of the newspaper at some point. So I am obsessed with the presidential campaign because you can't be. Like, I feel like I host a national radio show on SiriusXM. You should listen. But it's a lot. We talk a lot of important issues. But like the presidential campaign is unbelievable. No one ever. We thought it was going to be Bush versus Clinton, and it was going to be boring. It's not. It's amazing. The entire country is melting down. The Republican Party nominating competition is unreal. They've got two guys left at this point. Neither one of them will ever get anywhere near the White House. So you're just watching it going, holy shit, look at the meltdown. The Republican Party, it's all about like who's more masculine, who's the toughest, who's the strongest. It's down to these like three guys, two of which are not, I mean, Cruz and Donald Trump, they're crazy. They're just trying to out-tough each other, all right? They're just, everybody's like, Donald Trump, they asked him, what will you do about ISIS? And Trump's like, he's with the mic, he's always, I will bomb the shit out of ISIS. And Ted Cruz up here go, what did he say? I gotta out-man him, I gotta out-tough him. He's like, Ted Cruz, by the way, I mean, I think we can all agree that Ted Cruz, there's no doubt in any American's mind, even those who support Ted Cruz, that he has gotta be a monster in the bedroom, just a crazy right? Ted Cruz, it's a given he has a weird foot thing, I'm sure, right? But Ted Cruz, you know Ted Cruz likes to just be in leather underwear and get the shit kicked out of him. Hit me more in my fat face. Oh, he is the... Trump gets so much attention. Ted Cruz is out of his mind. Seriously, at some point, they're just trying to out-tough each other. At some point, they're just going to take each other's dicks out. Like, look at my dick! Look at my dick! And John Kasich's going to come in. I'm like, I have giant hands. I'm somewhat reasonable. And whoever the Democratic nominee is, Hillary or Bernie, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. At this point, America would elect a fictional character before they would ever elect Donald Trump or Ted Cruz. Seriously, if Cookie Monster ran and like he would be like, his platform would be like, cookie for me, cookie for you, and all of America would be like, I don't really think there's a choice. It's either a New York audience loves that, New York liberals. People in Arkansas are going, this bald-headed pedophile motherfucker, I'm voting for Ted Cruz and his fat, creepy face. They have no idea. It's unbelievable watching this shit. I love it. Like they're anti-gay. They're anti-everything but white people. That's it. You can't. They hate anybody who's Muslim, Mexican, black, Hispanic. I love it. I love it. I'm feeling the burn. Are you feeling the burn? Yeah. Also, I like Bernie Sanders. I have chlamydia. Pamela Anderson laughed at I have chlamydia. All right. I got one laugh. I was like, who's that? I was like, oh, hi. What does David Chervais smell like? All right. He was in Baywatch. Thank you. One person. One 40-year-old who, yeah. Yeah, and thank you. I think I'm gay. I do, because I'm married 15 years, and my wife, we have a great sex life, and everything's good, but like, there's not a lot of touching. There's not a lot of, like, it just, at this point, I feel like I just want to be held, sir. I just want to be held. I just want a spoon. If that's gay, I'm gay. It's fine. You're handsome, right? Had a weird, very strange. You ever had this happen, Pamela? Pamela, excuse me. Hi, how are you? Future husband talking to you. I'm in the bedroom having. We've been together 15 years, so it's not like the sex is like crazy, but it's good. It's good, and everything's going fine. I'm on top. She's enjoying it. I'm doing my thing. And our little dog comes flying in the bedroom. Yeah. Yeah. Yep. Little dog, like not a real dog, like a little tiny, like you're not even sure if it's a dog or an Ewok, one of those, you know, like got a... Dog jumps up on the bed and just starts licking my ass. My dog is just rimming me, and I know, that's gross. Let that marinate. The whole audience is like, this isn't funny at all. I don't disagree with you. That's the right reaction. But here's the thing. Here's the weirdest thing. I had this weird, fleeting moment where I was like, I mean, seriously, everybody's winning here, I feel. Who's, right, Pam? Come on. You're an animal lover, bring one in. Let it, listen. I'm 40. I've been with this woman, my amazing wife, 15 years. This is as close as I'm getting to a threesome. I'm just like, listen. All right, you guys have been amazing. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm out of time. Thank you. Thank you. Vote for Bernie. Vote for Bernie. 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 Pamela.
Live from the
Anderson.
Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Hadiyah Robinson is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on X's TV.
Central. Ladies and gentlemen, Hadiyah Robinson.
Yeah. All right. Woo. Yeah. I'm excited to be here, man. I feel good. I celebrated a birthday this year. Who's already had a birthday pass this year? Yeah? Yeah. Yeah. Happy birthday. It's about me, though. Calm down. Here's the thing. It was one of those monumental birthdays. You know, the birthday that changes everything for you, where you just become a whole new person? Yeah. That's true. It happened for me. I don't give a shit. Anybody else? Oh, yeah. It feels amazing. I don't care about none of the shit I used to think about. My homegirl called me, girl, we need to work out, because you know summer bodies are made in the winter. I was like, bitch, you should have called me last winter. Not doing that, no. Not doing nothing. Like, and you know, ladies, we have all the rules. When you meet a guy, he fine. You like, you know what, 90 days. Steve Harvey said it, 90 days. We got to go on 3 dates. It's got to be in a public place. Not now. Soon as I swipe right, get naked. Let's do it. Oh, yeah. Let's get it. And the thing is, like, you know, I'm concerned about wanting to find somebody. It's real. You know, I don't want to be alone. You know what I'm saying? The thing is, I'm really concerned about becoming a cat lady. That's, yeah. Cat lady fear is real. Yeah, she looking at me like, yes, bitch. I'm scared to death. When you're in your 20s, you see a cat, you're like, oh, a cat. You getting a little older, you're like, hey, get the fuck out of it. Nope, not today. It's pressure that older you get around cats. Like, when you're in your 20s, you don't worry about it. You know why? Because cats really they know it. They like, She not ready yet. They can tell. Yeah, they can tell. Now I'm at that age, soon as I walk home, a cat like, okay. They start following me home. I'm getting cat called by cats. It's true. They be like, ring. I'll be so excited. I'll be like, have a good day, Mr. Whiskers. Take care. Have a good day. Take care. I had a cat try to seduce me. This is how they get you. It's true. Coming home one day, I see a cat in front of me, so I stop. Because I don't know this cat. He might got a gun. I was concerned. Y'all, then the cat, like, just laid out on the concrete, did the sexiest cat move. I don't even know what to call it. It was just sexy. He just laid out in front of me, full cat belly. I don't know if you know about cat belly. Cat belly is magical. It's true, no matter what color the cat is, the belly is always pink. You wanna touch that beautiful cat belly. It's so tempting, it's like bubble wrap. You ever see bubble wrap around? You have to pop at least 3 bubbles on bubble wrap, or I don't believe you came from a good home. I believe, for real. Like, if somebody sees some bubble wrap and don't at least pop, 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 mm-mm. Your parents didn't love you. I can tell. I was leaning on the cat belly, too. Then I got in my right mind, I kicked it. Pow! Not today, Mr. Whiskers. Not today, I'm on my way speed dating. That's how you know you're still trying. When you get all the way down to speed dating, that's when you know you're still trying. Speed dating is the worst. Speed dating is Black Friday for single chicks. You know that day after Thanksgiving? When you run into a Walmart for a $5 TV and a VHS copy of The Last Dragon or some bullshit? Yeah. You don't really want it. You just don't want the person next to you to get it. That's all it is. You will leave with everything just as long as this bitch don't get it. That's what speed dating is. Now, if you've never been speed dating, right, it's guys on one side of a table, girls on the other side, right, and just sadness and desperation right down the middle. That's it. Just broken promises and old STDs. That's it. Lies and abortions. That's all that's separating you. That's it. That's the only thing between you. It's competitive, too, man. Last time I went, they set me next to a lady who was 60. First of all, you can't let a 60-year-old woman in a room with 20 and 30-year-olds. That's not fair. That's like me going to the high school. I'm gonna leave with whatever little boy I want, because I got, it's true. I got money for Jordans and all kind of PlayStation games. I'll be right outside. Come over here, Javon. What size is that? Come on, come on. About a 13? Come on. I'm gonna win. 60-year-old woman at the speed date. She ain't supposed to be here. She's supposed to be at home watching Matlock or some shit. I don't know. Leaving very awkward messages on her grandkids' Facebook page because she thought it was in the DM, but it wasn't. Just use the ointment I gave you for the rash pudding. Post. She wasn't supposed to be there. But she shut the game down. This is how the speed dating went, right? She talking to the dude across from her, but I felt like she was talking to the dude across from me. She was slick. She only had one question. She looked the dude right in the eye. She was like, hey, let's stop playing games. You like gravy from scratch? That was her only question. That was her only fucking question. That's all she did. Dudes on the other side of the room was like, is gravy here? I love gravy. The dude across from me got nervous. He was trying to be polite and concentrate, but I saw the little sweat bead going down his forehead. I was like, hey, you better focus. Don't look at her, look at me. My titties up here, I don't know what's happening under here. You better look. Couldn't compete. She won, y'all. She did. She went home with the dude across from her and the dude across from me. And I went because I needed to learn how to make gravy from scratch. I did. I did. You goddamn right. Yep. Sure did. Flour and water. Who knew? This old bitch is a wizard. First of all, older women use all the spices we don't use, ladies. If you're in your 20s and 30s, you only use 5 spices. Salt, pepper, garlic powder, cinnamon, seasoning salt. That's Mrs. Fields for white people. You know what I'm talking about. That's all we use. This old lady had dill, huh? Marzipan, huh? Cumin? Bitch, what are you making? That's my after-school program. I'm grown as hell, but I'll be at her house every day at 3 o'clock. What are we learning today? I'm old school, but I ain't as old school as I feel like I am, right? I try to stay hip, but certain things annoy me. Like, I got a text message from a friend, had too many letters in it after LOL. You ever got that? Friend gonna text me LOL, SMH, ROFTL, ATP, PTP, ZRB, huh? I was like, what do that mean? She was like, oh, that mean I'm laughing out loud and rolling on the floor and a titty popped out and a zebra ran by. Whoa. I smoked weed. I ran to the window. It's zebras outside, bitch? Who? Zebras outside. I text text short and sweet, because I think that's what text messages are supposed to be, short and sweet. We don't need all that extra information. I text her back, G-U-B. She gonna call me, what do that mean, gub? I ain't never heard gub. Who say gub? I was like, no, it mean grow up, bitch. And I hung up. You know, I be messed up. Some people try to do it, but they not smart enough. I paid my cell phone bill. The girl gonna give me my confirmation code one time. She was like, F as in phone. Caught me off guard. I was like, oh, they changed it. Okay. I'm like, no, ma'am, this is R as in wrong. What the hell are you talking about? I was like, how did you get this G as in job? Because... Look, you can tell who flunked the GED test. They ain't even laughing. Y'all, I'm Hadiyah Robinson. Thank y'all so very much, man.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Dante Nero is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on Axs TV. Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. More great stand-up coming your way starting right now.
Welcome back. Our next comedian is the host of the Beige Phillips Show on iTunes. So please welcome Dante Nero.
How y'all doing? Give it up for Pam. You know, I used to date skinny white girls, and then I broke one. That's why I like a bigger girl. I like a bigger girl, because come on, let's be honest. They're a little more, right? They're a little more sturdy. Biggest girl I ever dated, 512 pounds, big girl. Man, and I met her at a Baskin Robbins. She's standing by the counter staring at me like I was a 30-second flavor. And if you've never dated a big girl, do. It's amazing, because I don't even know how to explain it. Like, no matter where you grab her on her body, it still feels like a titty. Spent a lot of time sucking on her back, and titty fucked her calf once. One time she wore a belly shirt, her belly button looked like the cup holder on a Navigator. Just want to set the tone. You know, it's funny, I almost didn't make the show today because I couldn't find all my accessories. And then last minute, I know I'm a lot to take in, right? When you're like, ooh, who got tickets for WWF, right? Like, I'm a little intimidating. Maybe not now because there's witnesses, but like in a dark alley, holy shit! Then you can't really tell what I am. Like, people look, I'm like kind of like beige. Like, I'm like, is he black? Is he Spanish? Criminal, definitely a criminal. The rest of y'all looking at me like, why is the bouncer on stage telling jokes? I don't, fuck you. I don't know. Can't really tell what I am. Sometimes people mistake me for being Jewish. I get that a lot. Yeah, because sometimes I grow my sideburns long and curly. Sometimes I wear my do-rag five sizes too small. Maybe it's the way I say challah. I don't know. One day I'm walking down the street, this rabbi comes up to me, goes, Shalom ma, ata, Yehudi, nerek, kimo, Yehudi. I go, I don't know, maybe on my father's side. Some of you didn't laugh at that, but I'm a black guy, I'm speaking Hebrew. That's all you motherfuckers gonna, that's it? Thank you, ma'am. You have no idea how many fat Jewish girls I had to sleep with to get the pronunciation of that, because I'm a giver, I give back. It's great to be on stage, too, because I almost died. I don't know, sir, have you almost died before? Has that happened yet? No, it's coming, sir. It's on its way. What happened was I ripped my quads. I ripped two of the four quads. Did you know we had two four quad? No, me neither, right? It's quad, but I was like, all right, I'm the idiot. Fuck y'all. So I ripped the quad. Hey, I went into surgery to get it reattached, right? But the thing was, I have sleep apnea. Does anybody have sleep apnea? Yes, sir, you have a fat neck right there, sir. Yeah, you got sleep apnea. Come on, you know air can't get through that, sir, air. You don't know what sleep apnea is. You go to sleep and your body stops breathing for like 2 minutes and your body goes, hey, I don't know if you heard, but you're not breathing. Wake the fuck up. Then you go, right? It's great when you got a girlfriend because she watches you die over and over and over again. But when you go in for surgery, right, they give you the anesthesia, your body stops breathing for 2 minutes, right? And he goes, hey, I don't know if you heard, you haven't been breathing for 2 minutes. But the anesthesia goes, don't worry, you're fine, right? So I wasn't breathing, right? And then my lungs kind of started palpitating, and they created a vacuum underneath the vocal cords. They slammed shut, but it's like kind of like a Snapple bottle, but there was not no cool thing like giraffe's neck is 35, none of that. And then they had to intubate me. They put the tubes down my throat, and I started gagging. I'm like I'm gagging, right? And so you want to rip the tubes out of your throat, right? So they have to tie you down, right? So that you, that's not the funny part. This, I'm suffering, ma'am. I didn't get to the joke, ma'am. This crowd is retarded. So the tubes, I'm gagging. 3 days I'm in ICU gagging, like, right? I'm tied to the door. I'm watching the clock go around, and the whole time I'm thinking, man, you ladies and your blowjobs, you are amazing. Like, how do you do it? I'm like, this is so hard. Like, why do you, you're like God's little angels. I'm like, oh my God, this is so hard. The struggle is real, ladies. Thank you. There's a whore. See the whore? Woo, I'm a whore. So I wish that in my near-death experience I had gotten something like a road less, like something cool, but all I found out was I can't suck dick. That's all I learned. At least I know I'm not gay, right? Can't be gay and not suck dick. If you Google gay, suck dick is the first job, that's the first thing. Then there's the other thing, I don't want to do that either. But you can't be gay and not suck dick. That's like me being a plumber and be like, I don't like pipes. That's not for me. I did find out that gay dudes find me attractive though. I'm considered a bear. Some of you know. You don't know what a bear is, a big dude. Like you and me, we're like bears, sir. You and me, like kind of hairy. We could go to a gay bar and drink for free all night. We're like a fetish. Just, and all we gotta do is sit on the bench and giggle a lot and smile. They'll buy drinks for us for free. We can get drunk and shit. Then we just get up and leave and go, and they'll be like, where you guys going? I'm like, I don't know what kind of guy you think I am. I walk the fuck out. I go out with $60. I come back with $66 because I stole tips. I don't give a fuck. But it's not all gay guys that find me attractive. I know that because I was doing this joke and there was a gay guy sitting right where you are. No coincidence. And I was like, gay guys find me attractive. And he was like, no. I was like, fuck you. It's a special group of gay guys that find you attractive. It's called the Twinks. I don't know if you know what the Twink is. Twink is a little gay guy, 100 pounds. There's another one in the back. Made me think, like, me having sex with a guy 100 pounds is kind of like putting a thumbtack in the wall with a sledgehammer. Somebody's going to the hospital. It's probably not going to be me. Come on. Shut up. Stop crying. Wipe your butt. You asked for it. I apologize for that last punchline. That was too much. Wipe your butt was too much, people. I apologize. I don't know what I was thinking. How old are you, sir? 35. You look like shit for 35, sir. You look like you grew up in a coal mine if you're 35, sir. How old are you? How old are you really? Don't be a girl, sir. Just, nobody really cares. I would say you look great for 63. Give it up for him, 63. But you should say 73. They'd be like, wow, you look amazing for 73.
I'm 25.
Thank you. That's my mom. Screaming shit out. When did this become the Wendy Williams show? All I'm saying is a guy with that kind of, he has wisdom, you see. How old are you? See, you don't know shit. That guy knows things. 63, I don't know a 63-year-old guy who hasn't peed on somebody. Let's be honest, sir. Because as you get older, you get dirty. You don't mean to. It just happens with time. I'm 49. I'm filthy. I don't even mean to be. How old are you? Mmm, delicious. Bet you smell like butter cookies. Did I say that out loud? I'm sorry. I'm 49, I'm filthy, I don't mean to be. I eat pussy, ass, and feet. Not necessarily in that order. When I say that, young girls are like, ew, icky poo, right? And women over 35, they're like, wow, he's a lot more attractive now. Maybe he's a Capricorn. I feel like we have a connection. So I wanna make a confession tonight, and I don't care what you think about me. Every once in a while, I like a butterface. Yeah. If you don't know what a butterface is, a girl with a hot body, ugly face, she has everything but a face. In Australia, they call that a prawn because you pop the head off. I didn't make that up. Australia made that up. Here's why. Is this your girlfriend, boyfriend? No, just hanging out with a vagina for no reason. All right, whatever. Girlfriend here, yes. Very pretty girl, congratulations. When you have a beautiful girl like that, you can't make love to her the way you want to because she's too beautiful. Because you're like, is that all right? Did it hurt you? Is it too hot in here? Do you need some water? When you have sex with a butterface, you ride her like a rental car. You're like, there's a speed bump. Bam, I don't care. I'm taking it back anyway. Cause she's hot, but she's not. She's hot, but she's not. She's hot, but you're not. You don't know what your body doesn't know what to do. It's just like sweet and sour pork, sweet and sour, sweet and sour. And I don't cheat. I don't do it doggy style. I do it missionary style. I stare her right in the lazy eye, and I don't blink. I'm like, because I'm a gentleman, and my mother raised me right. You guys have been amazing. Thank you for listening, y'all.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Dave Landau is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. More great stand-up coming your way starting right now.
Are you guys having fun yet? Okay, our last comic of the night is making his third appearance on this very show. Ladies and gentlemen, Dave Landau.
Thank you. It's a mohawk. It's good to be here in New York. I'm from Detroit, Michigan, originally. Thank you. Yeah. Really? Tourism's down. The best thing about being from Detroit, we have our own anthem, which is Don't Stop Believin' by Journey. So anytime you're in a bar, restaurant, or Tigers game, you hear the line, just a city boy, everybody stops to go, born and raised in South Detroit. But the very next line to that song is he took the midnight train going anywhere. That means anywhere on earth other than Detroit. How's that for hometown pride? Hey, where's this train going? Who gives a shit? It's midnight in Detroit. Two tickets that way, please. Leave the baby, he can't keep up. We'll make a new one when we get anywhere. Should we sell the house? I don't really need $11. It's interesting, Detroit, to help revitalize the community, hipsters will move like next door to crack houses and do a thing called urban farming where they plant fruits and vegetables. And then you see them on the news and they're like, they robbed us and cut our faces open as a warning. Yeah, that's because you're fucking with their business. You know what people want to buy way more than fruits and vegetables? Crack. Nobody's ever sucked dick for an orange. That's never happened. I live in Metro Detroit with my wife, who just gave birth to our first child, which is really awesome. Yeah, it's great. Watching a baby be born is the most amazing thing I've ever seen in my entire life. It is absolutely a miracle. It really, the aftermath, that's a bit much. She's like, what does my vagina look like? I'm like, oh, it's good. It's nice. What does it look like? Like somebody kicked a hole in a pumpkin, I guess. And then just threw a wig on it for no reason. I just threw a wig on it. Because women shit themselves too when they give birth and no one tells you. Like, that's the first thing a doctor should say is, listen, you're gonna see some shit. Because you're just sitting there like a good husband, like push, push. The baby, push the baby. I'm sorry, doctor, I didn't realize she was such an animal. I wanna pay for your scrubs. And your baby's all covered in shit. You want to hold him? No. I'll shake his hand when he's five. And I'm a recovering alcoholic and drug addict. And now that we have a kid, people have questions. Like the other day, my buddy's like, well, like, what if you caught your kid smoking weed? That's a harmless drug. What if you caught him smoking weed? I'm like, well, seeing as he's a baby, I'd be impressed. I'm like, wow, did you roll that yourself? I thought you'd walk first. I think if my kid smokes weed by the time he's old enough, it's just gonna be legal. And remember how your dad used to tell you, like, I used to walk 30 miles to school, up and down hill in cardboard shoes. I was damn lucky to have. I would just do that shit to my kid with weed. I'd be like, oh yeah, did you go to the store to get your pot again? You got it easy. Back in my day, you used to have to page your drug dealer, and sometimes they wouldn't get back to you. So then you'd have to start hitting up other people's drug dealers, but they were dry, so you and your friends drove down to the shittiest neighborhood you've ever seen in your life and waited for somebody to go, caw-caw, caw-caw. And you'd go, woo-hoo, hoo-hoo, hoo-hoo. And they'd run out and sell you a dime bag of mainly stems and seeds. Possibly some fish food. You and your friends would roll up a doobie and get headaches. But you know what? You were goddamn lucky to have it, son. That's what I always loved about Dope Streets was just caw-caw, like a cop was gonna go, you know, I thought there was a drug deal going on over there. Clearly just a falcon talking to an owl. Falcons aren't indigenous this area. Owl, very wise bird, probably helping him back to his natural habitat. I think in 10 years, pot's gonna be legal and peanuts won't be. I really do. I think you're gonna have to meet a dude in an alley to get a couple grams of jiff. I'm not a cop. Like, all right, I got creamy, but for extra 20, I got that chunk. You know what I'm saying? Shit, straight nut. I got arrested 13 times, which sounds less severe if you say baker's dozen. The most I ever drank was an interesting time. It did end in an arrest. I was at a house party when I was 17, and my friend goes, you should bong a fifth. And I was like, you're right. So my friend Nick held out a beer bong while my friend Anthony poured in a fifth of Absolut Vodka. Yeah. Then my friend Jimmy goes, dude, that's fucking stupid, and pours in some Sprite, and he goes, now you're good. and I bonged a fifth. Now, I don't know if you know what happens when you bong a fifth. I will tell you. You tap dance for about 4 minutes. You tell your girlfriend who you love more than life itself that she has orangutan titties. You light a cigarette by the filter and you pass out face first into a glass table. The next day, the cops show up and you're still sleeping there. The parents have come home and called the police. They wake you up and they know you. And they look at me, they're like, hey, here's the deal, Dave. We're gonna call your parents and send you to rehab or you're going to jail. What's your pick? And I was like, we should do rehab, that'd be good. So they handcuff me to the back of an ambulance and they drive me to a rehab. But on the way there, they find out there's no room in the rehab, so I have to be detoured to a mental hospital. So I get to the mental hospital and I meet my counselor and he takes me to meet my roommate, like camp. So we walk down to this room, there's just this kid sitting there with this blank stare, and the counselor goes, Dave, this is Reese. Reese, Dave, get to know each other, you're roommates. He goes, what are you in for? I'm an alcoholic? What about you? I'm a werewolf. You don't really look like a werewolf. Yeah, I'm not a werewolf right now. There's not a full moon. If there's a full moon, I morph into a werewolf and I attack people. I come close to killing them. I don't remember it, I black out. Neat. All right, I'm gonna need my own room. This guy thinks he's a werewolf. Yeah, he's not a werewolf. Everybody has a bunkmate. You're gonna stay here. He has teeth and shit, so... Yeah, you're not getting your own room. So, about a week goes by. Being in a mental hospital, it's not that bad. You get to wear pajamas, watch a lot of TV. But one night, I'm going to bed, and all of a sudden, from the next bunk, I hear... Good night, Reese. This dude stands up, rips his shirt off like Hulk Hogan, tears his pants off like they're breakaways, and just starts going, roar, roar, roar. And I'm like, help, fucking werewolf. There's a werewolf. Where? This kid lunges at me, butt naked. I grab the lamp to hit him with it, and it's fucking glued down. So I'm just going, help, help me, help. He's a werewolf, werewolf. This dude's trying to bite my face, and that's not even what bothered me. He was naked. So all I could feel was his cock slapping against my leg the entire time. I'm like, werewolf, help, werewolf, there's a werewolf. Two counselors bust in the door, see him naked on top of me, and I swear to God, one looks at the other one and goes, what do we, let him fuck? Like, what do we do? Like, we're not fucking, he's trying to kill me, help. He thinks a werewolf, help. They stab him in the ass with a syringe, and they drag him out of there. I never saw him again. They could have shot that kid. I don't even know what happened. But I stood up, I'm like, I do not want to be here. I'm supposed to be in rehab, I'm an alcoholic. I'm rooming with monsters. I got a werewolf mushroom dick print on my thigh. I want to go home to my family. No more roommates. No more. Fuck. So the next day, they introduce me to my new roommate. This kid walks in. He's like, Dave, this is Ryan. Ryan, Dave, good to know each other. Yeah, hi, Ryan. What's your problem? What's my... Last night, I got attacked by a goddamn werewolf. Where was there a werewolf? And then I point in an empty bed and I go, he was just right there. Neat. Hey, I'm gonna need my own room, this guy. And that's how they make crazy people. Thank you guys very much. I appreciate it.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Pamela Anderson is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV.
You guys have a good time tonight? I can't stop crying. These guys are so funny. You guys have been an amazing audience. Now let's hear it for all of our great comics. Pete Dominick, Hadiyah Robinson, Dante Nero, and Dave Landau.